deals of cards as a meditation. And those he plays never suspect. He doesn't play for the money he wins. He doesn't play for respect. He deals a card to find the answer. Sacred geometry of chance, the hidden law of a probable outcome, the numbers lead a dance. I know that the spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know that diamonds money for this art, but that's not the shape of my heart. He may play the jack of diamonds, he may lay the queen of spades, he may conceal a king in his hand while a memory of it fades. The spades are the swords of a soldier. I know that the clubs are weapons of war. I know that diamonds mean money for this art, but that's not the shape of my heart. That's not the shape of my heart.
Ciao dear friends, ciao amici, meaning good afternoon, friends, humans, beautiful, beautiful humans. Yes, we are beautiful when we want to be, but in most of the cases we pretend we are not even humans. So let's flip our, you know, daily routine and start doing this once and for all, that it benefits you, that it benefits your beauty, that it benefits your stamina, that you find the words, that you find an action that is actually encouraging you, what you've done. Not what some outside propaganda forces, you know, Goebbels, Soros, or whoever forces on the outside trying to infuse you with doubts, with a cumulative fear that it's never basically gets released. Because fear is nothing else like too much food. What you do when you overeat, you kind of suffer for some time and then you actually release yourself on the other end. But they've kind of blocked a human body. They, I'm talking this deep shit aliens, creatures, manipulating us for literally hundreds of thousands of years, not to pay attention and to learn how to actually release our fear. How to release toxins from your body? First, you have to know that you're intoxified or intoxicated. If you don't know and somebody tell you, what people do mostly, they just jump on this person and start bashing over their heads. You liar, you make me do this, you putting curses on me and so on. Whatever. But anyway, I'm talking from personal experience, so don't take it too wrong. But in general, we did not learn how to get rid of fears from our energetics. And energetics includes your physical body. Energetics includes all your ailments. Fear in the body gets encapsulated somehow and producing more of the other very, very dark and sinister, let's say, vibrations, doubts, angst, and eventually, you know, just shoots through your physical and producing heavy illnesses. So, first thing first, deletion of the date of the stupido Gregorius Pope, the idiotic, you know, time messing timeline creature. 10th of May 2022 is by Gregorius being absolutely deleted. Today's real date is 27th of April 2022 by our dear friend Julius Assange, or Julius Caesar, or the Orthodox Catholic calendar. Putin is using it. So is he bad in this matter? What now if he becomes your spiritual lead, where and how to look into the world? So anyway, for you to ponder. Give a second. So, dedication for this. It'll be absolutely brilliant video. I can vouch for this. Goes to even more brilliant human being. So real, so genuine, and so powerful. Vladimir Vladimirovich Putin. My deepest gratitude to the being who's going through literally the most challenging and difficult job on this planet. Being a president of the Federation which is attacked for last couple of hundreds of years, always putting them down, yet they never crossed outside of the border to attack another nation. Never. It is one of the amazing hidden stories that nobody wanna say. I congratulate him on the Dan Pobede, or the victory day over the fascism, 9th of, it was just yesterday. It was a beautiful, beautiful, like a ceremony, they're celebrating it. Now 77 years when the Russians defeated Nazis. Yet, when we turn this around, Americans joined with the Nazis and hide the truth. So now it's a time for Putin fully to expose, well, it'll be gentle, but I hope it will be fast, that Nazis were still basically winning half of the war on the side of the Western Bloc. But on the Eastern Bloc, where Russians were fighting and they actually sacrificed tens of millions of its soldiers and population. And now this victory in Ukraine, that eradicating Nazism out, and all these Azov creatures and NATO's like a Black Lives Matter kind of crapsters are eradicated. And yesterday was a beautiful celebration. So I really thank you, Vladimir, for this genuineness of being here with us present. And I send you all my encouragements and healing energy, because I felt that you've been quite attacked. So thank you. Title: Synthetic Flat Earth, CIA PSYOP. Is it created simply to abduct you? And for what reason? Well, you all heard some of the events, let's say, through history. First World War, was it a PSYOP? PSYOP doesn't mean nobody get hurt. Actually, it's an opposite. PSYOP from the deep state, from the dark, dark, shitty creatures, is always done to inflict pain, deaths, destruction, massive amount of human souls fleeing the, let's say, earth plane, but they don't go too far. They've been captured. They've been redirected. So, Second World War, was it a real reason that suddenly Germany goes in the war against the Czech Republic, Poland, and then in 7 days it's conquered, done. But Russians start raising their voice. Serbians start raising their voice. They don't want to be part of this new Nazi, you know, United Europe, Nazi Europe at that time, talking 1940, 1939. So, PSYOP operations are done to inflict pain, to take ownership of something that is not theirs, let's say lands, resources, to enslave massive amount of people, like in the nation numbers, like nation after nation has been enslaved since Second World War until now. Only a couple of them, let's say, remained, and these couple of them, they were, if you just go last 30 years where the wars happened: Libya, Afghanistan, Iraq, Yugoslavia, Ukraine. So these were the, let's say, independent nations outside of the financial system. yet nobody talks about this. Why just these countries? Why Yugoslavia was senselessly bombed, NATO going in and splitting brother against the brother, eventually have 8 different countries, and each one of them now belongs to central bank, to Federal Reserve. Well, not now, but let's say at the time in 91 to 95, 95 to 99, and so on. Okay, this is like, it was 10 years of commotions in all Yugoslavia until it gets in little slices and pieces. Fall of Russia, USSR. In 1980, I think 7 to 1990, how many countries has been split from there? 28, all regional countries all around, including Ukraine, Kazakhstan, Chechnya, Uzbekistan, and so on. Like, it's a list, it's enormous. So it's like a huge number of people and the lands, very good lands, has been basically taken away, like peeled off. It's like onion peeling technique that the darks used on humanity, as now we're doing on them. But don't tell them, okay? So PSYOPs are almost like a mandatory toolbox for any decent and overt operations, because you don't disclose what you're going to do. You tell them, look over there, and this is, we're going to attack some Kakabanian, and then eventually they go in and they underground Ukraine, they build shitload of the dark technology with a massive amount of biological weapons and so on, like plus many more other shit that nobody is still even there to say it out loud. For what reason? But on the surface, there are Ukrainians fighting Ukrainians on the east, then on the west, and they're separating, and Donbas and Mariupol and all these regions are kind of in the war, but underground, let's say, or just in their midst, their CIA was building enormous harm for all the society, not just for the Russians or let's say Slavic people. Initial goal was to create a bioweapon that it kills only the Slavic people, all people with this gene that it comes from the Slavic origins. Yet, go back to PSYOPs back again. You heard Second World War, First World War, some recent ones that you can kind of get relationship what PSYOP really means. Nexium, fake books, googly google, AM zone, Amazon, IDS, SIN numbers, social insurance numbers, Smithsonian Institute, World Exchange, World Trade Center, let's say, stock exchanges, Monroe Institute, Scientology Church, these massive amount of mega churches, the Vatican, Roman Catholic Satanic Church, all the pharmacia corporations, pharmacy corporations, modern Medici systems, or medical systems. Democracy as a term turns into an oppressive mechanism over unaware people. Recent ones that you kind of can still see in the public eye. BLGTQASS crap. HIV, Corona. Plague in 1918. 9/11. 11/3, Fukushima. 1982, Chernobyl. Berlin Wall, when it went up, it was a PSYOP. When it went down, it was even bigger style. So, anyway, what are the reasons behind all this? I don't know. It's like a massive amount of energy was focused to really hoodwink all the humanity. I mean, more history. And so, like, let me stick only to a couple of them. I'm like, too much. Yeah. Synthetic flat earth. CIA psyop. The guy who supposedly created this within, they don't create it by one. This is like a complete team, like think tanks behind how they will approach certain agenda, how they will engage with the humans, male and females, to promote gayism, to promote hatred, to promote racism, to, I mean, all of it. It's like a massive number of so-called scientists, specialists in all the fields, trying to find a solution to actually control everybody through the psychological warfare. And this is where we sitting. We are in the midst of psycho war. I mean, psychos are all of us who are like chickens without a head, running around, not knowing where the bomb is going to explode, which kind of virus is going to eat you, which vaccines to take, A, B, C, booster 1, 2 to 27, and so on. These are all psyops. Yet, once when you see them, it's like so painful to talk to others because they are part of this psycho shit. They cannot even comprehend what you're talking. You want to save them, but they start smacking you, hitting you back, accusing you that you are conspiracy crapster or something, like anything that they've heard, again, as another sublayer of this mainstream media, there was another big psyop. Because the propaganda is the key aspect of psychological control. Tell somebody truth once, they will forget it tomorrow. But they'll tell somebody lie 30 times a day. Did you get vaccination? Vaccinate your children. Do this early before 8 o'clock, and so on. And every day, whoever is watching TV, like the CNN kind of type of programming, they are dead meat. They are like a zombies beyond any. So I'm always trying to turn into so-called somebody who can show even to these, the darkest of the dark, they are really not dark, but they are just like swimming into the shit pool, and they don't know they are in the shit pool. Yeah, it stinks, it's painful, it's hurtful, they are miserable, but they don't think they are, you know, they deserve, anyway, they think they deserve this. But I tell you different. You do not deserve all of these pains and troubles. This is not creation from creation. This is synthetic creation. So among any and many of these literally millions of little streams of psyop operations is the flat earth. Means what? What does it mean to you? Nothing, except it will separate you from basically your inner self and your knowing that this is absolute BS. But they want this separation between you and the creation. Who do you think will be kind of useless, and let's say God creating a planet where every single corner or every surface would be very, very beautiful and usable? So let's say you have a flat earth here, and you have houses here, mountains, and so what is underneath? Empty space, some kind of, you know, black goo thingy. So it's like kind of making like, so what, we're floating on some kind of black goo thingy? Okay, let me take you to this stream of thoughts. The key word in this sentence is synthetic. Synthetic creation is not from the organic stream. They use pieces of the organic, let's say, energy or source energy, and they're creating many of these so-called flat earths. Many. And they cannot really build the a round, nice ball that it's like fully utilized, like on the outside, many places on the inside, and so on. Yet, like this way, they make a square, basically they cut or replicate, like a photocopy, literally, squares of regions on the earth, or not even regions, sometimes even blocks of the town. And they're putting people inside there. They have like a key player who's some kind of mayor, and he's a tyrant, and basically they bring all the small pieces of other people who are in the real organic earth. Now they replicate them here on the fake earth or fiat earth. Fake flat earth, sorry, fiat flat earth. It's not, it's like this, it's like flat like this, but it's just a small fraction, one, let's say, cube of event. That is one event happening, 9/11, 9/11, 9/11, and they like living groundhog dog, a groundhog day all day long, all the time, just for the sake of this one producing, let's say, 9/11 commotion. We have 20-30 million people linked on this on this so-called planet, or on this synthetic timeline which you call flat earth, and they're siphoning the energies of fear, panic, na-na-na-na-na, all day, every day. They're selling, they're doing the galactic stock markets, were like using this as like the best product for looshing these synthetic timelines. But the real reason behind all this, I mean, this is like a preservation reason to, let's say, have enough food for them. They can live another 20-30,000 years without you even noticing that you're enslaved. But the real reason, they made a trick in 2000 years ago. Now, and they're doing this synthetic timelines a long time, but ascension time came 2000 years ago. Every 2016-17 years, ascension shows up. Creation Lightship comes in, prepares everything. We are doing all the preparations. All the beings involved in the creation of this region are actually engaged and just trying to help individuals who are ready to ascend. Yet, if the earth in itself is not ready to ascend, or it was so depleted, or basically siphoned out with the energies, none of the people can ascend, because we are very linked, like literally, we are creation of the earth, and we are creation from the creation, like in a combination. The material, let's say, comes from the earth, and the energetics and spiritual guidance comes, or spiritual carrier comes from creation. This was even hijacked as well. So many of these spiritual carriers were put in some kind of local quarantine. If you watch the movie Lo Sonar, like a Portuguese movie, one of the guys was writing about these kind of super elite spaces in the heaven, so-called, but they're just like a midterm. They're right hovering above the earth, and every soul that they died, they don't really go back to creation. They kind of go in this midsection where they get recycled, refurbished a little bit, cleaned up, wipe all the memories, and send them back for more suffering. So it was going on for literally 320,000 years in this kind of form. And these projects were so massive, yet so hidden that basically only beings who are, let's say, can pull themselves out of this matrix or mesh that was around us, around the earth, and around all the beings who comes in. Many light beings comes in and they get trapped because basically they did not have enough strength or knowledge or ability to basically go through this barrier back to creation to actually report. Well, some of us we did and we reported. And now what you see, it's outcome of our, let's say, really a big intent. Hard work has been paid out. Creator, Prime Creator came, observed, did a lot of cleanup that we could not do it on our own. And now it's time that we start seeing it as really is. So let me just close up with a synthetic flat earth. 2000 years ago, before the ascension really happened, and ascension is not something that is happening like in the moment. It will take, you know, a couple of decades to progress slowly, and then the build-up, communities has to build up, communication between the people build up, and that's where Jesus' time was totally hijacked. They took literally all this region when Jesus was in 2000 years ago present, and all the people came across him, and so they basically hijacked them and they moved them to synthetic flat line, flat earth. Ascension time, let's say, because its schedule goes through, finishes, let's say, the time frame. 17 people ascended. 17 beings, sorry. Because the rest of 200 million were hijacked and put on the synthetic timeline. But this organic earth remained. Yet, it was a lot of commotion and so on, like earth changes and so. So as, let's say, the progressing goes, 30 years later, they start bringing chunks of people back. So I think these Jewish Moses time, they went to where? When they went to the sand dunes and just in the desert for 40 years. They said, what, 40 days or 40 years? I think it was more like a 40 years. They didn't go in the Sahara or any of these local sand places. No, they've been actually hijacked outside of this planetary body. Return back, a bit confused. They start, you know, praying to the cows, to the golden chicken, and whatever. They've been kind of infused again with another psyop that was prepared for them over there. So they just replicate. This is what, you know, people's psyche gets used to. Like it's almost bred, and then you do to your children, to grandchildren, and so on, and you don't even think that there is a possibility to come out. And now what we're bringing more and more, it will take some 40 years or so. That's what we are here for, to show you the way out, if you choose so. If you choose so, but if you, man, you cannot stay ignorant anymore, because it's so much into your face that, I mean, you're wondering about everything. Now, the white hats or the light is using absolutely same technique against the dark ones and against the enslaved humans and the other alien species who are here in the same position as all the other humans. They were enslaved. Some of these species were basically so deeply enslaved, they were like through the DNA programming, through implants, through modulations of their genetic genome and so on, that it's horrendous what they've actually done to these alien species. They brought them here, they modulate them, they look like humans, but they are worse than the actual these overlords. They swing, turn around. Don't blame too much of your doctors or lawyers or government officials or this military dictators and so on. They just don't know they're not humans. That's all. Yet, now we are going through the process to actually give everybody a chance to learn their own lessons. And we'll use quantum system. Quantum financial system will be like a first step, and down the road will be used for education, for creation of the energy that we need for pretty much anything and everything. And quantum in your points, what does it really mean? Okay, I'll let you maybe answer, ponder a little bit, and then we talk some more.
And now the end is near, so I face the final curtain, my friend. I'll say it clear, I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full, I traveled each and every byway. Oh, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, but then again, too few to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway. Oh, and more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I faced it all, and it is my way. I've loved, I've laughed and cried, I've had my fill, my share of losing. And now, as tears subside, I find it all so amusing. To think I did all that, and may I say, not in a shy way. Oh no, no, not me, I did it.